Grade 7 math, number 9.5C, volume of a composite figure. So I've shown you this before in the previous video. Formula for the volume of a prism, it's V equals BH, the volume equals the base times the height. We can use that for any prism. And we've talked about how volume is a measurement in cubic units. It's the amount of space there is in a bounded region. There's no gaps or overlaps. We measured area, we found its length times its width. That's two measurements, so it was squared. Length and width, 1 and 2. Now that we have three measures, length, width, and height, 1, 2, 3, our answers are going to be cubed with a little 3 exponent. If this is 1 centimeter in all its measures, length, width, and height, it's 1 cubic centimeter. And the volume of a solid is the number of cubic units that fit within the solid. So that would be 12 units cubed, or 12 cubic units, see? Well, we can use the formula for the volume of a prism to find the volume of a composite figure that's made of prisms. So here we have two identical boxes. They're 10 inches tall, and their bases are 12 by 12, and there's a rectangular prism that's 8 inches long, 3 inches wide, and 3 inches high that's connecting them. Well, Emma's hamster lives in a double aquarium connected by a tunnel so it can travel to each side. What's the total volume of space her hamster lives in? So the first thing we're going to do is find the volume of each aquarium, and then we're going to add that amount to the volume of the tunnel. So the base of one aquarium is 12 by 12. See? 12 by 12, and they're 10 inches high. 12 by 12 is 144, times the height 10 gives us 1,440 inches cubed. But because there's two identical aquariums, we need to multiply that by 2 and get 2,880 inches cubed. Now we can do the tunnel. That's 8 by 3 and 3 inches high. So 8 times 3 is 24, times its height of 3 inches, gives us 72 inches cubed. We add that to the 2880 inches cubed and get 2,952 inches cubed of living space for her hamster. Okay? So when you're doing a composite figure, just find the volume of each prism separately. Find this volume of this rectangular one, then find the triangular one. Add them together to get a total of the entire volume, okay? So just take them each separately, all right? No big deal. You can do this, all right? Keep plugging, keep trying, and I'll see you next video. Bye.